those federations under CAF are going to go with the instruction from Issa Hayatou to vote for Sheikh Al Khalifa. It might not happen. It's not going to happen. There's a clear line division split in CAF, because where it is, a lot of the CAF presidents and associations saying, no. We want Prince Al Hussein. Take us through that.
Very interesting. Prince Al Hussein is from Jordan. The former president of Jordan, Prince Hussein's younger brother. And I guess he stood against Blatter, got about 73, Blatter got about 133, and Blatter eventually won over him. But I'll tell you what, CAF is a very disciplined organization. Mr. Issa Hayatou have run CAF with iron-fisted hand. And many federation presidents who have come against him have never survived in the bigger scheme of things. And if people are going to defy him, it's going to have consequence. I've got no doubt about that, because I'm a West African, he's from Cameroon, and I know how we operate. Yes, Musa Bility is on record as saying some will not listen to him. But Musa Bility himself stood, wanted to become a candidate for this FIFA presidency, and he was disqualified by the ethics committee. So you can look at what he's saying with a pinch of salt. You can't take it holistically. As of now, on Friday, only Botswana Football Federation had publicly come out to say they were going to support Mr. Tukio Sekwale. It would have been very nice to have a son of the soil being supported by his own moving into this FIFA presidency. Yeah. But I guess the campaign strategy of Tukio Sekwale have let him down big time.
Here's a question, Coudjoe. I mean, we had this conversation. It's a conversation we've been having for quite a long time now, since the CAF announced that they'll not be backing Tukio Sekwale. Is there reason to feel hard done? Let me put it that way, for Tukio Sekwale. Reason being, there were only 3 months to campaign for this election after Sepp Blatter and the 31 FIFA members were arrested.
Yeah.
SAFA have come out and said, maybe you didn't do enough in as far as that's concerned. Why should we feel hard done, or why should Tukio Sekwale feel hard done when there are people who have done better?
Let me give you a contest. When this whole hullabaloo started in FIFA, where executives were arrested in Zurich, there were talks within football and outside football that football is in such a mess that football people cannot restore the dignity and the trust of the organization by themselves. And therefore, the specs was, we needed somebody from outside football who's got a clout, who's got an economic clout, who's got a political clout, to come in and to be able to clean out. And all the specs were pointing to the direction of Tukio Sekwale.
Yeah.
And for me, I've pointed on several times that he stands a realistic chance of becoming a FIFA president. But I guess what I've angered Issa Hayatou and most of the African Confederation president is the manner in which Mr. Sekwale have gone about, in as far as his campaign is concerned. On the other hand, he says he doesn't need a job.
Yeah.
On the other hand, he says, no, nobody invited him. Really? You looking for election? You want to become FIFA president? You go to where people are. Nobody must invite you.
I think him going to the Ballon d'Or and snubbing.
He's going to Ballon d'Or, snubbing a WAFU conference where Khalifa and Al Hussein were busy lobbying. He was partying. He has been to US and he has been to Denmark. He has been to Switzerland and a number of European countries.
Yeah.
Where do your allegiance lie? Charity begins at home.
Yeah.
And that is where I personally have a problem. You've got Kalusha Balwa here, who is the president of the Zambian Football Federation, who has got an influence in as far as the SADC member confederations are concerned, and you haven't met him.
Yeah.
The countries that help to put you there, you need 5 countries to put you there in order for your endorsement to be accepted.
Yeah. Yeah.
You haven't even gone to them to say, I thank you for nominating me.
Yeah.
What kind of a campaign is that?
Let's do this. We've got a minute left. Another topic I want to touch on, ex of Cape Town. We know the saga happened to Kaizer Chiefs as well. Now we're speaking about football in Africa. They've come out and say they're not going to go to Angola. The host country has not guaranteed them their safety, they has not guaranteed their players' accommodation and things like that. What do you make of that?
Can I am very sad, I'm very disappointed by the withdrawal of Ajax Cape Town in playing in the CAF Confederations Cup, simply because that event don't have a lot of money and most clubs don't want to participate in it. By the time you go into the knockout stages, the money you have spent will be more than the money you earn. Mm. That is an open secret. Hence, Vers took 3-0 from here to a semi-amateur team in Klabanyati Rovers in Switzerland.
Yeah.
And they came home having lost through penalties. South African teams having changed their mentality in as far as African competitions are concerned, and it doesn't augur well. Hence, you find the young Bafana, the domestic players could not qualify for CHAN. And you look at DR Congo with all their problems. They have won the CHAN for a record second time. Yeah. They won the inaugural event in 2009 in Ivory Coast, beating Ghana, and they beating Mali comprehensively 3-0 to claim the tournament, giving their players a chance.
Yeah.
The best player of the tournament, Meshack Elia, came from DR Congo, from the DR Congo national team. And this is what we need to do. We need to change our mentality in as far as African club events are concerned.
I think
you are going there to play football. You are not going there for a party.
Coach, I think that's going to wrap it up. In fact, that brings us to exactly the point maybe with Tokyo Sexwale itself. The mentality of not probably respecting Africa enough could be his downfall come the election of the FIFA presidency.
In fact, I'll expect him to withdraw. Other than that, after the event, 209 FIFA Confederation members, he might come up with two, he might come up with three, and it will be a big embarrassment to himself, the country, and the continent, and it's not already. CAF advised him to stand down, and if
Coudjoe,
I were him,
Coudjoe,
I'll listen to him.
You have to stop with that. Unfortunately, you have to stop with that, Coudjoe. As I said, 20 minutes with you, I need it. Coudjoe Amankwaa speaking to us right here in Sports on Prime, speaking all things CAF, and particularly that topic with the FIFA president Tokyo Sexwale not being backed by CAF. Anyway, stay with us on Sports and Prime. We continue after this.